Ghost Stories of Shimla Hills by Meenakshi Chaudhary. First chapter, The Angrez Chudail. Sadhu, I am coming. Wait for me. Sadhu heard the wailing tone following him. She even knows my name, he thought, panic gripping him. He did not look back. Trembling with fear, he tried to scream and run, but he could do nothing. His feet seemed frozen. She was getting closer. His mouth ran dry, and his scream died deep inside him. His wobbly legs refused to move. Sweat poured down his forehead. Oh Bhagwan, bachao! I will offer 101 rupees to Ma Bhagwati, Sadhu went silently. Sadhu, wait! I am also coming, said the voice again, now closer to him. It was childlike, but it had an icy ring to it. He started sobbing and made a last effort to move. He gathered his strength and finally his legs obliged. He ran towards the brittle path leading to his house. He felt her following him and looked back. Her face had changed beyond recognition. Though still that of an Angrez, it was distorted and certainly not human. Now he screamed and in fit of horror ran blindly. The thing crying and laughing in the same breath was nearing him. He felt her at his back, almost at his heels, but this time he did not turn. He reached his house and wildly pounded on the door, banging it with his head, crying for help as he screamed. He fainted when the door opened. That night, Sadhu's entire family could not sleep for a minute. The woman stayed outside their door, howling, screaming and laughing the entire night. I looked at Sadhu as he was telling me about his experience. He was trembling with fear even as he spoke. He was a short man in his 60s with a crooked, prominent nose. I looked at him curiously. My nasal bone broke that night, he said, as if reading my mind. When did this happen? I asked. Nearly 20 years ago. I stopped my business at Baluganj after that and shifted to Chakkar. I do not walk in the dark on that road even now. It was a moonless night, I remember, he said. Sadhu is a roadside vendor who sold his wares near the bus stand at Baluganj, a small suburb of Shimla town, about 5 kilometers from Scandal Point. The area got its name from the two Englishmen, Colonel Balu and his younger brother. Both the Balus were known to be eccentric. The brothers had once received the commander-in-chief into their house, standing on their head with their legs up in the air. Baluganj is a junction from where many roads branch off. The main roads connecting Shimla with Bilaspur and other districts, one road turns left to Summer Hill where Himachal Pradesh University is situated, a broad path leads to Kamna Devi Temple on Prospect Hill and another road connects Baluganj with Chakkar. Sadhu, who lives at Chakkar and took this road every night after work, had to pass through a thick conifer and oak forest. The evening was like any other. There were very few people around the Baluganj junction and the vendors were beginning to pack up their wares for the day. Sadhu had not started packing up his stuff as he was waiting for the last bus. Just then he heard the rickety noise of an approaching bus before its headlights blinded him. The bus stopped a few meters away from where he was squatting with his products. The other vendors did not stop packing up, though they looked expectantly towards the passengers. A small group of men who had been strolling around the junction for nearly half an hour boarded the bus. An old woman got down from the bus, crossed the road and took the path to Summer Hill. The bus roared off, passing them all. It's 9 o'clock. Your long room bus has gone. Now pack up. Is it not enough to have sold and pocketed money for the last 12 hours? Asked Jeet Ram, Sadhu's friends for many years. Well, it's just that when you all start packing up, I get very confused. I'd rather wait for you to finish so that I can do it in peace. After all, it is a matter of 5 or 10 minutes more. Stop bluffing. I know you well. You wait till we go so the last customer will come to you because we would have packed and gone off, his friend joked. Anyway, see you tomorrow. Remember, it's your turn to sit in the middle. I will take this place as per my turn, he chuckled. They had been rotating where they sat for years, though it had hardly made a difference as far as business were concerned. It was a good arrangement psychologically. Both of them felt that the person sitting nearer the bus stop attracted more customers. In another few minutes, Sadhu had also packed his stuff and adjusting the 15 kilo tokra on his head, he started off. He was one of the few lucky ones to have a room close to his place of business, a mere 15 minutes walk. The house had belonged to his elder brother, a bachelor, and it had passed on to him when his brother had died. The path was shrouded in darkness. There was a slight October chill in the air. Balancing the tokra on his head, he pushed his hands into his pajama pockets. Sadhu knew every curve on the road. He had walked it twice a day for more than 2 decades. In a few minutes, he reached the 3 huge water tanks. He heard the gurgling and thumping sound of water hitting the bottom of the tanks. Sadhu stopped to adjust the weight on his head when he saw a silhouette a few meters ahead of him. Surprised, he looked intently into the darkness. There was no doubt someone was walking in front of him. "Perhaps it is someone I know," he thought and quickened his pace. As the distance between them reduced, he realized that the silhouette belonged to a woman. What was a woman doing walking alone on this lonely track? He wondered. "Where are you going, all alone in the night?" he asked softly so that his voice might not frighten her. There was no response. "Where do you want to go? I am also going this way. My house is nearby," he said again. Still there was no reply. Annoyed, he tried again. "Look, I am trying to help you. It's very unusual for a woman to walk alone late in the night. I do not have any other motive. I am a family man." Silence again. By now, Sadhu was walking alongside her. He could hear the shuffle of her feet. Something about the sound struck him as odd as he looked down. He could see her feet even in the darkness. They were white, thin and bony. She was not wearing any slippers and she seemed to be dragging her feet as she walked. He thought there was something wrong with her feet but could not make out exactly what it was. All of a sudden, Sadhu realized that what was wrong with them and his mouth went dry. He started trembling as the full meaning of whom or what he was walking beside sunk in. He knew about chudails from his friends. And the way one could identify them was that their feet were turned inwards. Terrified, Sadhu looked at the woman's face. It was beautiful and she was an Angrez. He was trying to figure out what to do when he heard her say, "Sadhu, take me with you."